Senior Pastor Superintendent Warren Goodson, to my pastor, the first lady of this great church, Jenna Cole Goodson, to all the elders, ministers, missionary deacons, and all you people of God. Also, I also give the highest respect to my mom and dad. The man I chose to speak about was the prophet Balaam. Balaam is best known as the doctor for having the doctor speak to him in Numbers 22-24. I'm going to speak with the New Living Translation, when you have it, say amen. And it reads, but God was angry that Balaam was going, so he sent the angel of the Lord to stand in the road to block his way. As Balaam and two servants were riding along, Balaam saw the angel of the Lord standing in the road with a drawn sword in his hand. The donkey went off the road into a field, but Balaam beat it and turned it back into the road. Then the angel of the Lord stood at a place where the road narrowed between two minor walls. He was sent by Balaam, king of Moab, to produce curse unto Israel. He told Balaam to give blessings unto Israel, but he had not returned to Balaam. As well as being known as the donkey god, Balaam is known for Balaam's anger. Here, in case you didn't know, anytime you ask you to make a new phrase to try to describe a stupid action, it is a bad sign. Balaam disobeyed the Lord by returning to the king, Balak, the king who wanted to curse God's people. Balaam, riding his donkey, is confronted by an angel of the Lord. The unordinary thing in the story is that the donkey can see the angel of the Lord, but Balaam is unable to. You might say Balaam is spiritually blind, so he cannot see the angel. This is unordinary because Balaam is a prophet, and prophets were to receive direct communication with God, but he was disobedient and he could not see him. The donkey was starting to see the angel of the Lord. He stopped the road several times out of fear, thinking his donkey had gone mad. Balaam started to beat the donkey until the donkey had, "Why have you beaten me three times?" And then Balaam's eyes were opened to the angel of the Lord and his sin. I mean, if you be disobedient towards God, you will miss out on a lot of things God has in store for you.